has him covered, and he drops it off, though. And look out, gets left, shooting, and a save made. Corey went to the net for the rebound. Pass to Malkin. On the left wing now to Jokinen. Jokinen tried to center, and it's broken up. And it comes back on the wing. Little shot, and he scores. Derek Engel and rifles it past Hiller, and the Penguins have tied the game.
Derek Englund has scored some beautiful goals this year for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Not in the lineup last night. Boudreau shaking his head. But we've seen this here in Pittsburgh. And once again, a defenseman is scoring for the Penguins. Derek Englund this time goes 5-all in the first shot of the game against the Swiss netminder Jonas Hiller. And it was a hard wrist shot through traffic and through the wickets of Jonas Hiller. And just like that, the Penguins.
4 minutes last night. The Penguins had to go with five defensemen against the Sharks. And we got a fight here at center ice. Right off the draw.
Maroon. Glass.
Patrick Maroon and Tanner Glass. Maroon leads their club in penalty minutes. Trying to get that right hand free. Glass just has that right hand cocked at the moment. Murray unleashes it.
Maroon's got a visor on steady.
He looks big and strong, doesn't he? The Glass is hanging in there with him. He's got a good grip on that jersey. Now he gets that left hand free, but I'm not sure he connected with that.
Glass is talking to him and smiling at Maroon.
He's punching while he has a fist full of jersey in that left hand. Maroon. There's a right from Glass. He'll just let him go. Finally, they've had enough.
Well, for me, those three words, let him go, were the most feared words in hockey. But for those two combatants, they line up at the faceoff circle. Glass and Maroon, a couple of little pushes, and that was all it took.
Glass used to get into fights with his uncles.
Big numbers playing hockey.
And you were his linemate.
The greatest sport on earth.
Now Vitali draws a penalty with that speed. Brian Allen takes him off his skates.
Great speed by Vitali. He's got the size, the desire, the hunger.
Remember the penalty he drew in Nashville the other night coming up the near wall? He does it again here tonight.
Yep. Coming down that off wing, chipped it around a man. He's able to draw a penalty. That was against Leguan in Nashville. And here drawing a penalty to put the Penguins on the power play. They're going to call him for diving.
What? He got the can opener.
Yeah. We saw this Gotch get called for this the other night.
Well, what he did was kind of squeeze his legs together there on the stick as he felt it between the shin pads. I don't think I've ever seen a guy go up in the air like that. He was flying.
Long, arduous playoff. There's the slash by Kunitz right there, the one-handed slash. Oh, look at Perry. And then Kunitz and Perry line up on the faceoff later. Oh, and there's Kunitz faking like he got hit in the hand by Perry. Was that awesome stuff or what?
Head now for Palmieri, who steers it in behind the net. Luxorp again after it. Corey Perry on him in front. Gets left to Perry, and he scores. A two-foot pass right on the door.
Take a look at the whack. There's the whack on the hand. See Orpik? He loses his top hand, his right hand on that stick. He can't play the puck. And they get three players down.
Hands
there.
It off to Crosby. Up top to Malkin. Oh, he can't keep it in. And they'll go back and regroup. Taken now by Crosby. Neal with it. Malkin in the slot. Fires and he scores! Evgeny Malkin ties it at two. Another power play goal for the Penguins.
Oh, that's deadly. That is absolutely an assault by the Pittsburgh Penguins on their power play. That passing is, that's something special. Every day working on it at the end of practice. Even when Malkin lost the play, they got the puck into the zone. They took a hit to make a play up there at the blue line. And look at the Kunitz in front providing that traffic on Hiller. That is hard work. That's getting your feet moving. That's desire. That's taking advantage of an opportunity. And your power play.
The Ducks.
Ducks win the draw. Fowler stolen away by Sidney Crosby. He's trying to pull away from Lovejoy. In on goal. The save made by Hiller. The rebound swept aside. Now over to Lindholm. And he'll lead the charge along with Perry. Drops it off to Getzlaff. Cross ice. Look out. Beauchemin in front. Lindholm. Great save. Rebound. Another big save on Getzlaff by Marc-Andre Fleury.
Right up and over and through the uprights here to Getzlaff, trying to go up high. He went up real high.
Number 18.
Here goes Neal. In on Hiller. James Neal shoots, and Hiller with that catch in glove on the right hand makes the save. As you said, it might be a different look.
Yeah, indeed it is. For Neal, who's been really good as the first shooter for the Penguins, tried a quick shot on Hiller. Hiller makes a beautiful save, and now the Ducks have the advantage.
Number 13,
Nick Bonino. Stopped by Fleury.
Oh, I love Fleury. Bonino in the high slot looked up, and Fleury flashed his leather. Flashed the mitt. Watch the glove. Right there. Just a little something to make the shooter think.
Listen to the crowd. They're all on their feet. They know who's getting ready to shoot.
This is great.
This is great stuff. Crosby swinging wide this time. Crosby scores!
That puck has got eyes sometime. Crosby turning it forehand, backhand, a cradle here and a zigzag there. And somehow it bangs it off the left pad of Hiller and in. Look at this stuff. He's using the edges, using the back of the forehand. He had it all going there, didn't he?
Yeah, he gave me a little TJ Oshie action there.
Yeah, right? A little swagger.
I haven't seen him do that in a while. This is Palmieri coming with speed. Poke check by Fleury.
Wow. As he's doing cartwheels, the stick comes out for Marc-Andre Fleury. Touches up the post. Watch the stick and the cartwheel.
Let's see if Malkin can finish it off here against Hiller. Evgeny Malkin against Jonas Hiller. And he loses the puck, shoots it, and at that point he's at a tough angle, so that evens it up.
Well, maybe he should have taken that right to the net once he picked it up in the corner here. Just take this right to the net. You can't go backwards. You can take it and make your move. Nonetheless, that's tough because that ice, remember, they had ice problems prior to the shooters.
Now Marc-Andre Fleury has an opportunity here against Corey Perry, and Corey Perry scores.
Wow, Perry wound it up, and then he took this long route to the net and goes glove hand on Marc-Andre Fleury. Fleury's hand went up, and I think the puck went under the glove. Yeah, just over the stick and over the left toe, under the glove, and we're going to the four shooter. Pretty good four shooter here, Steggy.
He's 0 for 5 this year, Jussi Jokinen. He's due. Finn against the Swiss goaltender, and Hiller with a glove save.
That's the difference. The goalie carrying the glove there. That's where Jokinen likes to shoot, and normally he comes with a wide swing from the right side, but he came straight down Main Street and threw it right into that glove hand of Hiller.
Up to Fleury now against Jakob Silverberg. Here comes Silverberg against Marc-Andre Fleury. In on goal. Fleury makes the save, and we keep going.
Good patience. Standing up, waiting for Silverberg's shot, not dropping down too low in that butterfly, Fleury. One pad down, one pad up.
Excellent. Former Duck, Chris Kunitz. He's been very good in the shootouts.
You know his magic. Swing to the right, maybe fake a five-hole shot.
There's the swing to the right. There's the fake. There's the shot. There's the goal.
There it is. We didn't want to tell Hiller. Fake that one and come back to the backhand. The former Duck. There's the leg kick, the fake to the five-hole, to the backhand, and elevation.
And now Teemu Selänne has a chance to keep it going, or Marc-Andre Fleury's going to win it if he stops him. Let's see if Solani can score and keep it going. Here he comes. He scores.
Well, that was a little hitch and a little chip shot as Solani glides to his right. A little hitch right here, a little fake. Just turned the blade, didn't move the puck, just moved his stick. And that got Marc-Andre Fleury to bite. He went for the hook, and Solani went upstairs.
We go to the sixth.
This is fun.
It is, and here comes Sutter. He has a game-deciding goal this year in the shootout. In on Hiller, Sutter scores on the backhand. Wow. And who will shoot in the bottom of the sixth?
Good stuff. Backhand up high. Hiller deep in the net. Getzlaf.
Yep. It's not bad, you know, when you can get to the sixth shooter and it's Ryan Getzlaf, second leading scorer in the NHL.
He likes to shoot. He may try to go to high glove. Let's see.
Let's see if Fleury can stop him. Getzlaf swings to his right, walks in. Fleury says no, and the Penguins win. They get the extra point in Anaheim. A big bounce back win for the Penguins here tonight.